Well, hello there.
Tonight we are going to take a look at working with exponents and a little bit about the laws of exponents. So we are on your notes page that looks like this. A little bit of vocabulary. We're talking about exponents, which are also known as powers. The base is the factor that's being multiplied over and over again. In this case, our base is 4. The exponent tells the number of times the base is a factor. How many times we stamp it. So that just means if I had 4 as a stamp, I would stamp it 3 times and get 4 times 4 times 4. Why don't you take a look and do quickly 1a through d. So 1a, 3 to the 4th, I think of that as 9 times 9, or 81. 8 to the 3rd, a big number, 512. 2 to the 5th, 32. And 2 to the 6th, then, would have to be 64. Now, be careful if the base is a negative. We have to write it out to be sure whether or not our solution is going to be positive or negative. In the case of negative 2 to the 4th, I have 4 negative 2s, and so for every pair, the negatives cancel out, and I get a positive. So my answer is actually positive. Negative 12 squared, well, that's negative 12 times negative 12, or 144. Negative 7 to the 3rd, I have 3 negatives now, so 2 of them are going to cancel out, 1's going to be left over, negative 343. Likewise, negative 2 to the 5th. I have 5 negatives. So 5 negatives, 2 pairs walk off, and 1 guy's left alone, negative 32. And the last one, negative 3 to the 4th. We got nice pairs, nobody left over, and my answer is positive 81. Now, a very different situation than negative 2 to the 5th is 2 to the negative 5th. Those are very different answers. All right. In order to see how negative exponents work, I would like you to complete this chart up to 2 to the 1st. So 2 to the 5th we just saw is 32, 2 to the 4th, 16, 2 to the 3rd, 8, 2 squared, 4, 2 to the 1st. Each time we lower the power by 1, we divide, in this case by 2 because 2 is our base, right? So 32 divided by 2, 16, 16 divided by 2 is 8, 8 divided by 2, well, 2 to the 1st, what's 2 divided by 2? 2 divided by 2 is 1. Therefore, 2 to the 0 is 1. Now, what is 2 to the negative 1? Well, what's 1 divided by 2? It's 1 half. So essentially, that's 1 over 2 to the 1st. 1 half divided by 2 is 1 fourth. Oh, I can write that as 1 over 2 squared. What's 1 fourth? Here comes your fraction work, people. 1 fourth divided by 2. 1 fourth divided by 2 is 1/8, which I could write as 1 over 2 to the 3rd. So what's happening here? Well, basically, if I have negative exponents, they are creating fractions. So look at my rule for negative exponents. For any non-zero number a, because remember I can't have 0 in the denominator, that's going to be a black hole. And any integer n, a to the negative n is 1 over a to the n. What does that mean? 5 to the negative 2 is 1 over 5 squared, 1 25th. 3 to the negative 3, 1 over 3 cubed, 1 27th, etc. Let's do some examples. 5 to the negative 3. Well, 5 to the negative 3, it's 1 over 5 to the 3rd, which is 1 125th. 7 to the negative 2, 1 over 7 squared, the 49th. 2 to the negative 4, got the hang of it? 1 16th. 8 to the negative 2, 1 64th. And this tells you what I said above, which means you have to be careful where the negative is. So 15 to the negative 2 is 1 over 15 squared, or 1 over 225. Negative 15 squared is negative 15 times negative 15, which is plain 225. 3 to the negative 3, I did that for you up above. And negative 4 to the 3rd is negative 4 times negative 4 times negative 4, which is negative 64. Now, I'm not sure if you have these at the bottom of your notes, but if you don't have them, I'd like you to write them. I'd like you to just take a look at the first one. This is very important. So the parentheses serve a purpose in math. They are grouping that negative with the 2. So this is negative 2 times 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 negative 2. Right? That is positive 64. This second example is negative 2 times 2 times 2 times 2 times 2 times 2, which is negative 64. They are different problems and they have different answers. Keep that in mind if you have a question on that. I will talk to you tomorrow. We're going to move on and do some rules for multiplying and dividing like bases. So in order to do that, I want you to first write these problems out the long way. 2 cubed times 2 to the fourth. Write it out and tell me what you get for each of these. Go ahead and pause the video and come back and check. Okay, so for the first one, you should have gotten 2 to the 7th because I had 3 2s and then I had 4 2s, and that's 7 2s. Here, I had this times, this. That's 3 to the 5th. My goodness. 4 squared times 4 to the 1st is 4 to the 3rd. So to multiply exponents with the same base, now this is key. These have the same base. This isn't 3 squared times 2 to the 4th. Those are different bases. Can't use these rules on that. But if we have the same base, we add the exponents. So I can write this algebraically and say a to the n times a to the m equals a to the n plus m. Go ahead and tackle those next several examples. All right, so 7 to the 5th times 7 to the 4th is 7 to the 9th. This is m to the 10th. And the last one, 6 to the 9th. Now, it said to be careful with these, so I could only combine the ones that were like, and I should have gotten a to the 7th, b to the 5th, and x to the 5th, b to the 8th. Now, you might say, where did I get the 5th? Well, remember, when I don't see a power, it's 1. So 4 plus 1 is 5. So now we're going to take a look at division of like bases, and we can write it out the long way, as I did with the first one. And if I have 4 5s in the numerator and 3 4s in the denominator, those 3 4s in the denominator cancel with 3 of the 5 4s in the numerator, leaving me with 4 to the 2nd. So 2 to the 5th, I would have 5 2s in the numerator with 4 2s in the denominator, and those cancel, and I'm left with 2 to the 1st. 5 3s in the numerator, 2 3s in the denominator, I'm left with 3 3s in the numerator. And 7 5s in the numerator, 4 5s in the denominator, leaves me with 3 in the numerator. So to divide exponents with the same base, we should subtract the exponents. What does that look like algebraically? It looks like a to the m over a to the n equals a to the m minus n. Fancy that. Okay, try and finish up this page for me. Okie dokie. So here we have the answers for the subtraction piece. Remember that if I have a variable with no exponent, the exponent's actually 1. So in number 2, I get x to the 3rd. In number 4, the x has no other variables in the denominator with the same base, so he just stays as is. In number 5, anything divided by itself is 1, so I get technically 1s to the 1st, so I just write s. And the last one, this is something I'll be going over more frequently, but this is not considered final simplest form. Whenever you have a negative exponent, you should express it as a fraction. So we know that 5 minus 7 equals negative 2. That's how I got my exponent of negative 2. Alrighty, excellent work tonight. We are going to take more extensive look at exponents in the next class. So have a wonderful evening, and I will see you all then.